give several pauses while we speak. Similarly, when we write, we use punctuation marks to indicate those pauses. Comma is one such punctuation mark. Comma indicates a slight pause. A comma marks a slight break between different parts of a sentence. Used properly, commas make the meaning of sentences clear by grouping and separating words. So commas help in making the meaning of sentences clear. Let us see how. Commas are used to separate two noun phrases next to each other that refer to the same person or thing. So two noun phrases, then they should refer to the same thing. They should refer to the same thing or same person, and they should be next to each other. Like, so if you read this sentence, it goes as, Keats, the great English poet, died young. Now, if I read this sentence like this, it does not make a lot of sense. In this sentence, Keats refers to this person, and the phrase, that is the group of words, the great English poet, this entire group of words or phrase also refers to this person. So I have two noun phrases which are next to each other. So Keats and then this phrase, and they refer to the same person. So I need to separate these using comma. So how can I do that? So for separating, I put a comma after Keats and I put a comma after this phrase. So this becomes Keats, comma, the great English poet, comma, died young. How do I read it? Keats, the great English poet, died young. So this great English poet is actually describing Keats. So this is another phrase for Keats. It is describing Keats. So I need to separate it using commas. Now if you see, I have put a space after comma and there is no space before comma. Another thing to notice, that is, how do you check whether you have put commas in the correct place or not? So just read the sentence without this part, the part between the two commas. Read the sentence. It will be Keats died young. It makes the same meaning. It gives the same information. Keats died young. So this is additional information, but the sentence makes perfect sense even without this information. So this means that we have put commas at the correct place. So Keats died young is the same as Keats, the great English poet, died young. So this is an additional information. This is referring to the same person, Keats. So this is how you can separate the noun phrases referring to the same person or thing using commas to make the meaning of sentence more clear. Now look at this sentence. Kohli, the captain of the Indian cricket team, is a great batsman. Now over here, Kohli refers to this person. Also, the captain of the Indian cricket team refers to this person. This entire phrase refers to this person, that is Kohli. So these are two noun phrases referring to the same person, and they are placed one after the other. This phrase, the captain of the Indian cricket team, is giving additional information about Kohli. So I put a comma after Kohli and I put a comma after this phrase. So the sentence becomes, Kohli, the captain of the Indian cricket team, is a great batsman. So this is additional information that we are giving about this person. If I read the sentence without this part between the commas, It will be, Kohli is a great batsman. So the sentence makes perfect sense. It gives the same meaning as this sentence, just the additional information is missing. This means that commas have been put at the correct places. Now look at this sentence. The US President John Kennedy was known for his inspirational speeches. Now, the US President refers to John Kennedy, and John Kennedy also refers to John Kennedy. So over here, these two refer to the same person and they are placed one after the other. So should I separate them using commas? If I separate these two using commas, and if I read it without the part between commas, what will it become? The US president was known for his inspirational speeches. Is it giving the same information? No, it is not giving the same information, because it is not telling us which US president. There are many US presidents over time. So it is not telling us which US president in particular are we talking about. We are talking about John Kennedy. But if we don't include John Kennedy, then it doesn't tell us which US president are we talking about. So the US president John Kennedy, this entire thing actually refers to one person. Until and unless we say John Kennedy, saying just the US president is not sufficient. So we cannot separate these two using commas. But if I say John Kennedy first, John Kennedy, the US president, was known for his inspirational speeches, then I need to give commas here. Why? Read it without the part between the commas. John Kennedy was known for his inspirational speeches. It makes perfect sense. The US president is giving us more information or additional information about John Kennedy. So we can do without this, and the sentence will make perfect sense. John Kennedy was known for his inspirational speeches. So I need to separate these two parts using commas. So this is correct, and even this is correct. But if I say John Kennedy, the US president, was different from John Kennedy, the husband. Now in this case, John Kennedy, the US president, this is one identity. It means John Kennedy as the US president was different from John Kennedy, the husband. This is another identity. So I don't need to put commas here and separate it, because this entire thing is the identity. That is, John Kennedy as the US president was different from John Kennedy as the husband. So this entire thing is the identity. This entire thing is another identity. So I cannot separate these parts using commas. So we can use commas to separate noun phrases when they refer to the same person or thing. But be careful when you separate them, the meaning of the sentence should not change. So even if I choose to read the sentence without the part between the commas, it should make the same meaning, and it should make the meaning clear. So take up different examples of this type and try putting commas at the correct places. If you like this video, then subscribe to our channel. You can also register for free at deltastep.com to get all the learning resources as per CBSE, ICSE, IB, Cambridge, or any other curriculum. Over 5,000 amazing lectures on maths, science, English, and social science. Our unique interactive video technology keeps you engaged, and our iDictionary feature allows you to quickly revise any concept. Master each topic at your own pace with our adaptive practice technology and 1 million plus questions. Get instant answers and detailed solutions. Be exam ready by taking unlimited mock tests, performance analysis along with actionable feedback, personal tutors to resolve the slightest of your doubts. And that's not all. You can also win exciting prizes like PlayStations, iPads, watches, and many more, along with certificates through our Earn As You Learn program. So at DeltaStep.com, learning is not just fun and easy, it is rewarding too. So register for free now.